have no limits! Whoever my opponent, their might is nothing compared to mine! I will crush them!
Ayo! Boop! What up? What is going on, guys? Detective Juris is here. Now, you're watching this video because you want to make a lethal, exotic, crazy, dominant slasher. Yo, hold on. That sounds kind of crazy, but you know what I mean, yo. You want to grab that bow. You want to come down the lane. Don't matter if two people down there, three people. You just want bang on center, speed boost and playmakers. Bang on everybody. So you know I'm going to provide you with the best information. We got tweets coming from LD. We got Mike. A whole bunch of screenshots. Like, it is insane. All the information that's coming out. So you know, I had to get on top of my game. There really hasn't been a lot of information, so I wasn't gonna make a video. But you know what I said, we got all this info to talk about today. This topic is gonna be strictly just slashers. And then we, you know, we have community day, which is coming tomorrow. So you know, Detective Jerks, I'm gonna be looking like yo, let me write this down. You know what I'm saying? So you already know the vibes, man. If you haven't already, my boy, hit that like and hit that sub button. The goal is to get it to 14.1. Right now we have 14,048 and nothing but blessings. Thank you guys so much. I hope nothing but the best for you to grind in 2K20. But enough of that. Let's get straight into the slasher information. This is insane, bro. Look at this. Watch this. Look. Like, what? Bro, that is going to be very lethal. So keep all this in mind. This video is just straight about slashers. So I'm gonna break down the pros and also the cons. Wait, hold on. You thought I was done? Like, I was just gonna show you speed boost and layup? Bro, look at this right here, bro. Look at this. I gotta bring out the news, and you know what I'm saying? If that's how I feel, then I gotta say it. Now, Mike put out a tweet not too long ago, you know what I'm saying? We're still polishing right now, but slashers are very strong in our current build. Probably need to be nerfed a little, if anything. Yo, Mike, what are you talking about, Mike? What are you talking about? 2K19 was a 50-50 ratio. Either you dunk in a ball or you're gonna go in there and get some ugly ass layup animation that you can't time. It made no sense. It made no sense that little ass guards were stopping full bump pure slashers from dunking a ball. It made no sense. Of course, other people were happy that weren't slashers, but slashers felt like they wasted VC and they wasted a whole build. They got badges, Hall of Fame badges. None of that really mattered because the mechanics of the game. It really didn't even matter if you had a Hall of Fame poster visor. The mechanics of the game is what defines the animations. You know what I'm saying? If you don't get the right animation, you're not getting that dunk. You know what I'm saying? So, like I said, with everything that's good, there always comes bad. So I don't know if this video is new or that player just wasn't a slasher. I'm not too sure, but there's a video of a slasher already doing 2K19 things. Right here on the screen. Look at this. What? Mike, the game ain't even dropped yet. You know what I'm saying? I don't know, maybe this player wasn't a slasher, but look at this. Like, the dude was basically already there, bro. I pray he wasn't a slasher. Like, that better be the water boy, you feel me? Like, that better be the coach's son. You either want to be a short slasher, the speed boost, or you want to be a tall slasher. But lack of speed is a big difference in 2K20. Now, we look at the ball. Man's got the ball, you know what I'm saying? 23 is running. But look at the guy trailing him, number 12. He is so behind. So when you make a slasher, do not make your slasher heavy or make him too tall because you want a higher contact dunk number. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Sometimes it's good to try to like balance it out. You know what I'm saying? I think in 2K18, I was like 6'7", tall slasher, right? But I was only like 205, which is light. But at the same time, I had a contact dunk of like a 94, and like, bro, this man was literally booming on everybody. So necessarily, you don't have to always go with such a heavy weight to get crazy dunks, because to me, I feel like speed kills every single time. So if you got a slasher and you're beating your defender down the lane, bro, you're gonna get that dunk. If you're a little bit heavier, it gives your defender, the opponent, to kind of like defend you a little bit. Like, listen, if you're a heavy slasher and you're playing defense, you're not catching up to that guy. You might as well flop and just stay right there. You're not catching up to that guy. Number 12 is so damn slow. is so disappointing, but I'm excited because this cuts off the ratio of bigs running the same speed as guards. It made no sense. It's okay, 19. Shaq was literally running the same speed as Kyrie. No sense at all. So I'm definitely excited about this. You mother effing stretch bigs. Y'all not gonna be able to run down this court, dribbling a ball, running up and down. It is over. It's over. Next thing I want to talk about, you know what I'm saying? So this is a slasher video, is the badges that we know about so far. We already know there's about like 80 badges. There's park badges. But when you're creating a slasher, bro, these are certain badges that I want you guys to keep in mind. Now, the one that I'm looking at right now is slippery off ball for shooting. Bro, this is a lethal badge because it is more success with the off ball juke moves to lose defender. Now, as a slasher, if you do that and you juke them, you could go straight to the rim and your man throws you an alley. There is no way to defend that. That is definitely going to be lit. You juke him, whatever, get past him. There's one guy down the lane, but guess what? If your point guard has IQ, because I hate dumbass point guards that don't have IQ, but if he has IQ, bro, that's an automatic contact dunk because the dude is, he's going to be down there, not ready, and you already have a speed boost because you're gone because of this badge, and that is definitely going to be lit. Like, that is going to be crazy. Now, another thing, of course, playmaking. If you're looking to make a playmaking slasher, quick first step. What does it say? Blow-bys. What? Blow-bys and speed boosted? That already speaks for itself. Like, what do I gotta tell you? Like, that's gonna be crazy. Ankle breaker, you already know, causes twerks? Like, people gonna be twerking on the court, bro? Handle for days, bro? What? Like, this is crazy, bro. But, you know what I'm saying? Those badges, I definitely want to keep you in mind, which is quick first step and slippery off ball. I think those badges are going to be crazy, if not lethal, for slashers. Then, obviously, we got some slasher badges right here. You know what I'm saying? Of course, hot start, which is microwave, definitely going to be important. But, you know, contact finisher, you know what I'm saying? Obviously, you're going to want that. But right here is another one. Fancy footwork, you know what I'm saying? Passes defenders with advanced Gatherson on the floor like Euros. That is also another badge that you want to keep in mind. You know what I'm saying? You know, acrobat, the finisher badge, like those are things that you want, but I definitely want you to keep in mind of those playmaking badges as well as these slasher badges. If you get these badges as a slasher, I promise you, you're going to be very dominant in 2K20. And on the screen, I got a couple other badges. Like I said, not all the badges have been released, just everything that we know of. Now, Eraser's not coming back. Now, I don't know where that badge is from. I don't know if that was from one of the old 2Ks. I don't remember that badge in 2K19. There's no way that was in there. I don't think that was even in 18. I don't know. Maybe that was like a 17, 16. I have no idea. If you know, comment down below. But Eraser's not coming back. Here are the blocking-related badges. Taste Down Artist, Heart Crusher, Intimidator, Pogo Stick, Rim Protector. Now, off the rip, you know what I'm saying? Chase Down Artist, you know what I'm saying? Smacking that ball on a rim, LeBron style. You know what I'm saying? Heart Crusher. Like, what is that? That sounds crazy. Intimidator, very dominant, bro. Pogo Stick just sounds like you're going to be jumping off the wall, out the gym. Don't know. And Rim Protector. So, will Defensive Stopper be returning? Defensive Stopper was removed, you know what I'm saying, because of content specific badges. Now, what is Heart Crusher? That's what I want to know. Heart Crusher knocks down the other team's takeover meters when you get a block or steal. Intimidator busts the defender's impact on all block contest attempts. So that is definitely dope. So, you know what I'm saying? Intimidator busts the defender's impact on all blocks. I don't know. It's one of those things that I gotta see for myself. Like, I gotta see, you know what I'm saying? And then Pogo Stick, it sounds like a defensive jumping up and down kind of thing. Explain that more. Helps cut down the compression and decompression on block attempts, allowing you to jump repeatedly faster. Whoa! Wait a minute. This sounds like it's for lockdowns. Like, this is about to be crazy. Or if you make a slashing lockdown, you're about to be blocking the ball, putting it on the backboard, smacking it out the gym, smacking all the way to Annie up. This sounds crazy. Pogo stick, basically, you're going to be able to jump up and down. The whole you're going to be able to jump up and down, bro. I can already see. Can you imagine a rim protector just standing in the paint, just jumping nonstop? Like, what? That right there might be a problem. If you're a lockdown, if you're a rim, you're probably excited. But me, no. I'm not excited about that. Yo, I ain't gonna lie, 2K. This might be an OP badge right here, man. Like, bro, I got that Hall of Fame pogo stick. Like, what? What are you talking about? That might be crazy, bro. That might be crazy. On the screen. You know what I'm saying? I've been going back and forth. I've been talking to LD. You know, most of the people who watch me know that. You know what I'm saying? I've been talking to LD. You know what I'm saying? I try to sneak in there. I'm like, yo, might not get a response. Can you at least say your favorite build so far? He tweeted, well, you know what I'm saying? He wrote back, not yet. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to get stuff at him. So if you guys have any requests and whatnot, let me know. You know what I'm saying? And LD does respond. So we could definitely get a lift for the slasher community. But I ain't trying to make this video too long. I don't know if it's already too long. Anyways, but it's your boy Jerz, Detective Jerz, here for 2K20. Stay blessed. Who knows what we're going to do next? And please, can we get the goal to 14.1? It's your boy Jerz. Stay blessed. Who knows what we're going to do next? Oh, yo, community day tomorrow. So put them noties on. Put them noties on. I'm going to be dropping bangers. It's your boy, and I'm out. Yeah.